Coach, got the season starting here this week with the Bison Classic. Just kind of preview the season here now that things are getting fully underway here.
Yeah, it's kind of reopening the season is the way I like tend to look at it. We had a good meet in December. Had some nice surprises from some of our young people. Now it's kind of like getting a box of Cracker Jacks is what I refer to it. We'll see what happened over the Christmas break. Hopefully we get some nice prizes in that box. But sometimes we get some duds as well. And, I think that's part of the maturation process, I think, for a lot of young people in track is understanding how important the Christmas break is and what they need to do and how much they dictate the terms of the conflict by their workout abilities over the break. And, unfortunately, it wasn't a great weather break. That might be the understatement of the early part of 2018, but some kids obviously made the efforts and got some things done, and we're happy for what we've seen so far. And we'll find out more this week, and then hopefully we'll get to Fargo and really kind of find out where some of our kids are at.
What are do you feel the strengths of this team so far?
Well, I think the men's team's balanced all around. That meet in December, Bryant Quarter had an outstanding meet. He had two marks that were, probably very close to still being in the top 10 in the NCAAs in the long jump and triple jump, and he had a great year last year. We've got some solid throwers. NDSU has some really good throwers, so it doesn't make us look quite as good, but we had Mason Lyseth from the football team who joined us briefly during the outdoor season last year. We've got some good sprinters. We also added Daniel Clark from Jamaica, who's now here, and obviously we've had some really good success with our distance program, and we anticipate that to continue. I think maybe we get a little bit slower start because of the weather. A lot of those kids kind of depend on what's going on over the break. And then on the women's side, it's a very, very young team, and hopefully it's going to develop, but we've got some good upperclassmen leadership in Savannah Dolezal in the sprints, and then Rachel King in the distances. And Casey Vollmer was more of an outdoor athlete in the throws, but that's a group that we just try and get better every week and stay positive and just trying to be the best that we can be.
Flip side of that, any weaknesses maybe you're looking to improve here in the next couple of weeks and meets?
We just got to get fit. You got to train. I got to be smart. We got to avoid sickness. It's a short season, and if we want to be in contention or do some special things on either side, we got to have the focus that it's going to take to get that done. And kids need to understand that it's particularly the first year kids, it's not a high school season where you can work yourself into shape, although we'll be forced to do that in some cases. This is the big leagues, and they'll get a taste of it a little bit this weekend, and when we host the Jim Emmerich meet next weekend, it'll slap them hard in the face.
You talk about being a short season. How important are these meets here?
Everything's important because you're fighting to get on the conference roster. We've got probably double the athletes that actually can compete at the conference meet. So if you're not getting it done, your season's going to be even shorter. And I think it's the goal of any athlete to be able to participate in the conference meet. The energy, the excitement of a collegiate conference championship meet is really what these kids compete for. So much goes into that kind of finale where champions are crowned, and the experience that personally I had as a coach last year, I don't think I'll ever forget that, because it was so exciting to be involved all the way to the bitter end of that meet that I'm looking forward to this season again.